Hi everyone, welcome back. Today we're making this cute little squirrel, the little fluffy tail. This is almost the same pattern as my little trouble teddy that I just released last week. This one here is on this channel already, and also a written pattern on my blog. The difference between these two is the head shape. You'll notice that this squirrel has a bit more of a different head shape than the trouble teddy, and also the tail, of course, and the ears are different. So I decided to put it in its own video so you don't have to flip back and forth between anything. This is a whole video for the squirrel itself. So it's in two parts. Part one is how to make the head and the body and how to stuff and shape. And then part two is how to make all the parts and how to sew it together. The yarn I'm using for this project is Red Heart Comfort Yarn. This is the same yarn I use for all my amigurumi. It's 100% acrylic. It's a medium weight number 4. If you'd like the color code for this little guy, it's in the written pattern. I'm also using two different hook sizes, a 3.75 for the head and body, and a 4.5 for the rest of the squirrel. I'm also using a blunt and yarn needle. And like all my patterns here on YouTube, there's a written pattern as well. You can print this off from my blog and follow along. It includes the supplies list. You can find the link to this written pattern in the description box below. So if you do make yourself a little tiny squirrel, I'd sure love to see it. Post pictures on my Facebook page, Amigurumi Freely. Thanks so much for watching, and have fun! We're going to make the head and the body. The head and the body are all one piece. We start at the very top of the head, right here, and we work our way down to the bottom of the body. We're going to use our smaller hook for this part, the 3.75mm. And row 1 is a loop with 6 stitches. And I'm going to show you the method that I use. It's called the magic ring, but there's actually two different methods you can use to get this loop. And I have videos for both those methods linked in the description box below. But I'll go over the method that I use, which is the magic ring. You're going to take this shorter yarn tail, and you're going to wrap it around these two fingers twice. And then hold that yarn tail in between your pinky and your thumb, and then hold the working yarn between your pinky and your thumb. Then put your hook through, yarn over, and pull through. Yarn over and pull through. And that was my slip knot. Now I'm going to put 6 single crochets into this loop. When I go through that loop, I'm going to be going through both strings and then yarning over and pulling through that loop. So let's do the first one together. Going through, yarn over and pull through. Yarn over and pull through. That was 1 single crochet. I'm going to do 5 more. Going through, yarn over and pull through. There's 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now we need to close up this circle, so we're going to hold on to this end here with our thumb and our finger. And we're going to pull on one of these two yarn strings to see which one closes it up. Oh, I got lucky that time. It's the first one. So pull it all the way. Now we need to get rid of this string, so we're going to pull on the yarn tail. So there's my loop with 6 stitches. If you need further help with this, like I said, there's 2 videos linked in the description box below. And I go through 2 different methods of getting this loop, and I go very slowly. Row 2 is 2 single crochets in each one of those 6 stitches. You'll notice if you turn it towards you, the stitch looks like a V. And there's 2 loops in that V. When you push your hook through, you want to make sure that you're going through both loops of that stitch. So we're going to go ahead and put 2 single crochets in now. So yarn over and pull through. Yarn over and pull through. That was 1 single crochet. Now going back in the same stitch I was just in, and put another one. Going into the second stitch now, going to put 2 single crochets. Going back in, and there's 2. Going into the third stitch now, put 2 single crochets. On to the fourth, 2 single crochets. On to the fifth, 2 single crochets, And last time for this row, into the sixth, two single crochets. Now if your piece is folding up on itself like this, that's totally normal. This is the wrong side, and this is the right side. You just want to make sure that you're working the right side, so flip it to the right side. Make sure that you're pushing the yarn tail, where that starting yarn tail is coming out of, push that inward. Right side, wrong side. Now you need a stitch marker. I just use a piece of yarn of a different color, and I push through my last stitch I just put in, pushing right through. I'm going to lay my yarn over my hook and pull it through. Just pulling one yarn string through and leaving the other one hanging. And we're going to move this marker at the end of every row. So that was the end of row 2, and now we have 12 stitches around. We've added our marker. Row 3 is one single crochet in the first, and then two single crochets into the second. And then we're going to repeat that, 1, 2, 1, 2, all the way around. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in two single crochets. So one in the first, making sure you're going through both loops. And now two single crochets into the second stitch. One and two. One in the first. And two single crochets into the second. Repeating again, one in the first. And two single crochets into the second. Repeating again, one in the first, and two single crochets into the second. One in the first, two into the second. And remember, if I'm going too fast, just pause the video and catch up, and when you're ready to start again, hit play. Now for the last time, one in the first, and two is going to land on that marker, so we're going to pull it out and put in our two single crochets. That's the end of row 3, and now we have 18 stitches around. Let's move our marker. Ready to move on, and the piece is folding up, so I'm just going to turn it right side. Rows 4 and 5 is one single crochet in each one of those 18 stitches for two rows. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in one single crochet and then move that marker. One single crochet in each one of those 18 stitches for two rows. So I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here at the end of row 5. Remember to move your marker at the end of this row. So I just reached the end of row 5 and I've moved my marker. I'm just going to stop and show you how to count the rows. Always count behind your marker, and counting the rows, you're just counting these rings. So I just finished row 5. I should have 5 rings. We start down here with the loop we started off with. And that's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Row 6 is 2 half double crochets in the next 3 stitches, and then one single crochet in the next 15 stitches. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in one single crochet. So a half double crochet is pretty much like a single crochet. You just yarn over before going in. So yarn over, then go into your stitch like you normally would, grab your yarn and pull it through. You have 3 loops, yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. Now we're going to put another half double crochet in the same stitch, yarn over, go in. Now 2 half double crochets in the second stitch, yarn over. And there was 1, going back in the same stitch, yarning over first, and there's 2. And now the last time, 2 half double crochets into the third, yarn over, and there was 1, going back in the same stitch, and there's 2. And now 1 single crochet in the next 15 stitches. So 1 single crochet in each one of those 15 stitches. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in 1 single crochet. I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. I'll finish row 6, and then we have 21 stitches around. Row 7 is 1 half double crochet in the next 6 stitches, and then one single crochet in the next 15 stitches. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in a single crochet. So yarn over before going in, one half double crochet in the next 6 stitches. There's one, two, three, four, five, and 6. And now one single crochet in the next 15 stitches. So I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. At the end of row 7, and we still have 21 stitches around the starting yarn tail, I'm just going to tuck that into the piece so it's out of my way. Row 8 is we're going to crochet 2 together 3 times. So 2 stitches together 3 times. And then we're going to finish off the row with 1 single crochet in the next 3 and then 2 together. And repeating, when we land on the marker, we should be crocheting 2 stitches together. I'm going to work this row with you, so don't worry. So when you crochet 2 together, I always go through both loops. And for me, that works fine. So you just go through the first, and you can go through the second one, grab your yarn and pull it through. And now you have 3 loops. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. And we just crochet 2 together. But for some of you, crocheting 2 together can cause gaps in your work. So if you're seeing gaps, just go through the front loops. You go through the front, grab your yarn, pull it through. Go through the next front loop, grab your yarn, and pull it through. You have 3 loops, yarn over, and pull through all 3 loops. So either method will work. So that was, we crocheted 2 together twice, now we need to do that one more time. So either both loops or front loops, your choice. Go through, grab your yarn, pull it through. Leave that loop on your hook, go into the next stitch, grab your yarn, pull it through. You have 3 loops, yarn over, and pull through all 3 loops. So we just crocheted 2 together 3 times. So when you're working in small rounds, when you crochet 2 together, it's very easy to go back into those stitches that you crocheted together. So make sure you're not doing that. There's the ones we just worked. We want to get into the next stitch. One single crochet in the next 3. There's 1, 2, and 3, and now we're going to crochet the next 2 stitches together, and remember, if you're seeing gaps, just go through the front loops. And now repeating, one single crochet in the next 3, and 2 together. I just went through both loops. And now repeating for the last time in this row, one single crochet in the first, one in the second, one in the third, and now crochet 2 together. You can see it's going to land on the marker, so I'll pull it out. This time I'll go through the front loops. So we're all finished row 8, and now we have 15 stitches around. We're going to move our marker. Going through those last stitches I just crocheted together and pull my marker through. Row 9, we're going to continue decreasing. One single crochet in the next 3 stitches and then 2 together. So again, make sure that you're getting into the first stitch of the row and not going back into the stitches you just worked. One single crochet in the next 3. There's 1. I'm flattening out the piece because it's a little bit easier to get in that way. There's 2, 3, and now crochet 2 stitches together. You can go through both loops or go through the front loops, whichever method you prefer. And now repeat that, 1 in the next 3, and then 2 together. I'll go through the front loops this time. And for the last time in this row, one single crochet in the next three. And then two together is going to land on that marker. And we finished row 9, and now we have 12 stitches around. We're going to move our marker. Row 10 is one single crochet in the first, and then crochet two together. Repeat all the way around. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting two stitches together. So this row, you want to take your time, because it's getting quite a bit smaller. It's a little bit more difficult to get in and crocheting stitches together. So there's one. And this is also the row that people will probably start seeing gaps in their work. So remember, you can crochet through the front loops when you're decreasing. That was two together, and I'm going to repeat that. One single crochet. And then two together. Repeating, one single crochet. And then two together. And now repeating for the last time, one single crochet. Remember to take your time. And two is going to land on that marker, so I'll pull it out. So we're finished row 10, and now we have 8 stitches around. That's the smallest round you're going to have to work in with this pattern. We're not going to get that small again. We're going to start increasing the body now. Just going to push that marker inside there, get out of my way. Row 11 is 2 single crochets in each one of those 8 stitches. So 2 single crochets in each one of those 8 stitches. There's one, going back in the same stitch, and there's two. Two into the next, one, and two. Two into the next. One and two. And remember, if I'm going too fast, always just you can pause the video. One and two. One and two. That's the end of row 11, and now we have 16 stitches around. They're going to be a little bit more bunched up because we worked in a small round, and we also put 2 single crochets in each one of those stitches. So just make sure in your next row that you're getting into the right stitch. Row 12 is 1 single crochet in the next 3 stitches. 1, 2, 3, and then 2 single crochets into the 4th, and then you repeat all the way around. When you land on the marker, you'll be putting in 2 single crochets. So you can always stretch this part out so you can see the stitches better. One in the first, one in the second, one in the third, and 2 single crochets into the 4th. And you're going to keep repeating that, one in the next 3 and then 2 into the 4th. Remember, when you land on the marker, you should be putting in 2 single crochets. I'll continue on with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. At the end of row 12, and now we have 20 stitches around, we're going to stop and stuff the head now. So just pull out your last stitch so you don't lose it. Just pull it out and leave it hanging. And we're going to stuff the head. You can see it doesn't look like this. We have to stuff and shape it to look like that. So the part where we put those half double crochets, that's the muzzle part right here. So we want to make sure that when we're stuffing the head, that we stuff all in the proper areas. And this little guy takes lots of stuffing. So just get the majority in there. So when I talk about shaping, what I mean by that is pushing the yarn in the right area. So first of all, I'm going to push it into that muzzle part. You can see it sticking out there. And then when I put the rest of it in, I want to make sure I'm getting stuffing all in this area. So I'm going to use my finger and push it all in that area. And that should do it right about there. Now we can add our marker. Row 13 is the same as the last row. One crochet in the next three stitches, and then two single crochets into the fourth. And then you can repeat that all the way around. When you land on the marker, you should be putting in two single crochets. So one in the first, one in the second, one in the third, and two single crochets into the fourth. And then repeat that sequence, and we'll meet back here when we land on the marker. I'll finish row 13, move my marker, and we now have 25 stitches around. Row 14, we start to decrease, one single crochet in the next three stitches, and then we're going to crochet two together. And then you repeat that all the way around. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting two stitches together. So there was three, and remember when you're decreasing, if you're seeing gaps, to crochet in the front loops when you decrease. And if you're not seeing gaps, don't worry about it. One single crochet in the next three. And two together. You can go through both loops or front loops, it's up to you. I'll continue on the pattern, I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. I'll finish row 14 and now we have 20 stitches around. I've moved my marker. Row 15 is the exact same as the last row. One single crochet in the next three stitches and then crochet two together. Repeat all the way around. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting two stitches together. I'll continue on the pattern, I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. I'll finish row 15, I've moved my marker. We're now down to 16 stitches around. Row 16 is the last time we're going to crochet. We're going to put one single crochet in the next two stitches and then crochet two together. And repeat all the way around. When you land on the marker, you should be crocheting two stitches together. I'll continue with the pattern. I'll meet you back here when we land on the marker. One in the next two and then two together. I'll finish row 16. Now we're going to slip stitch into the next stitch and finish off. So just go in, grab your yarn, pull it through. Instead of yarning over, just pull the first loop through the second loop. Now you can finish off. Leave a bit of a tail for weaving in and out of those remaining stitches and closing up that gap. Pull the yarn tail through that big loop and pull it tight. Now we're going to thread our yarn tail. Instead of pushing the end through the eye of the needle and risking fraying that end, just bend it over and push the bend through. Now we're going to weave in and out of these front loops of all the remaining stitches. In and out of the front loops only. Okay, so now we can pull in this yarn tail and close up that gap, but before we do that, we want to stuff the body, of course. And again, we're going to shape as we stuff. So we want a nice, fat little body when we're all done. So I get the majority in, and then I close up the gap just a little bit to hold that stuffing in while I push more in. I'm pushing all the stuffing in all around the bottom area, and then I can close this gap up a little bit, just pull on that yarn tail, and I can push more stuffing in there. I can use the back end of a pen or a pencil. So you can use anything that will fit in that little gap there and push the stuffing in. I push it all around this area here. So I think that's pretty good right about there. So now we can pull in this gap all the way. Just pull tight. Now we can knot this off. And then pull the yarn tail into the body. Pull it anywhere through a stitch hole. And then cut free. So that's the end of part one. You can head on over to part two. You'll find that link in the description box below, where I show you how to make the limbs, how to make and brush out the tail, and how to add in the ears, and also how to do the face. So we'll head over to part two now and get the rest of the squirrel made.